Happy Tuesday, everybody. It's Tuesday, January 16th, 2018. Hello, I'm Bryce Castillo. I'm your pre-show navigator. Hi, everybody. I can't see this monitor with these glasses on. Hi. Where's everybody? That's where all you guys went. Hello. It is incredibly cold here in Austin, Texas. I believe when I looked, it was... Look at that. It's 26 degrees. That sucks. Oh, boy. Shane asked, were the roads awful? Not really. No. You know, it was... more cold than anything. I'm sure there was probably some ice when it was snowing or frozen raining for, like, what? 45 minutes? 45 minutes. But otherwise, it was fine. You know, I only got here slow because I drove here slow. There was nobody out on the roads, which is good for me. But also, it's late at night. It did end up meaning we postponed the bizarre briefing, which we were going to do this afternoon. And it also meant that we pushed back the stand-ups we're going to go shoot until after Night Attack, where it will be even colder. But it'll be nighttime. And we want to deal with, you know,
businesses that are open.
Thank you again for the raid, Mike TV Live, of course. What does it say this time? Megalosaur, give me your ultra megalodon. Yeah, hey, there you go. It's from what is it? What's that song called? Paleophile? Dinophile. Jurassophile. I think it's Paleophile. Hello, everybody. Oh. So, it's Tuesday. I mean, Night Attack's going to start in about an hour. I'm going to tell you ahead of time. I don't know how long the pre-show is going to be. I'm sorry, the post-show. Because like I mentioned, we have to go shoot something after this. But in any case, I'm glad we had you. Hey! We did something fun in the pre-show. That's where I play music, and we just get ready. We get everybody in here, so when the pre-show starts, we're all good. Well, we had a mini project, sort of based off of our little fun toy at the end of last week's after show. We went back to the botnik.org website, plugged back in Diamond Club, the novel, and had everybody play Number Wang. And those numbers have turned into the following segment. A man about the investment, he wanted more going. I winked his dick, couldn't to me after. It had began, gently rubbed my ass, became aware of it. But he didn't his dick throbbing the back entrances earlier at his nice and wet, with the flash on his chest against. I looked around her head. His overalls had started falling into. I knew she replied while the various. She moaned in the air and came on the toilet. Love walking for me, he says, the back corner behind me. I don't was no sign. When? I knew that my ass, with a few tails, the... I could feel the passionate fire burning. I felt confident plans and began to message Sasha. On me, that drink on the lips, am I. There you go. Yeah, that was fun. If you missed last week's after show, there's a predictive text... keyboard that here I'm gonna put a link in the chat where you can put in a text file of whatever and it'll do some sort of neural network thing and it'll create a predictive keyboard of what's probably likely to come up after X word. And so, you know, we use numbers to make that segment. Captain Outer says, Captain of Outer Space is cool. Hat Bryce, thank you. This is So this was something I got over the weekend at a little place you might have heard of called Devan Busters. It looked like this about 8 hours ago. It was a normal black hat with the word selfie on it. And I loved it because it was awful. It was incredible. Incredibly bad. The backside said winner on it. And it was incredibly earnest. It was way too earnest to be any good. And so I wore it a lot when I was down at PAX over the weekend. But then I was like, oh, I probably don't know how much I can wear this. But it was fun to think of a way to mess with it. So I went and I got, I don't remember the brand now, but they have glitter paint. And so it's, let's see, where can we put this? So it is like the cap part is like all glitter paint, which also means it is incredibly rigid. The backside does not seem to bend in at all. And then the brim, I actually, or the brim, what's the brim? The bill? Whatever. I did a couple of layers or a couple of coats of a chalk, like a matte chalk, just to give it an interesting texture, and it makes it even more matte compared to the original fabric. I don't know. And it was like, oh, it was super cool. And like the glitter almost distracts away from the fact that you can definitely see it says hashtag selfie embossed in the top. but it was also just fun to, like, I don't know, paint this thing. And it was super easy. And I could just get any hat and paint it. So I don't know. I don't know. It was fun to do, and I might do it again. Thank you, everybody who I saw at PAX. Link Slider and Sunbun in the chat, of course. Still photoed here in this photo of me. The hashtag premium fuckboys. And we just had a good time. It was a good time getting together with everybody. You know, drinking. Mostly drinking. We spent the first day, I drove up on Saturday, and we spent pretty much that entire day at Dave & Buster's drinking those fucking watered-down, expensive-ass drinks. But anyway. So that's that. That's your PAX report. Oh, man, I want to save this. I kind of want to save this for when Brian is here. We received a gift that I think it's been talked about on the show, so I don't know that it's going to surprise anybody what it is. But we got a special social eating from a special country. And I think Brian would want to try it. I wonder if it says anything. Would have to have a number that I'm looking for on it. I don't see said number. In any case, hello. Let's take a look at some funny stuff, huh? You want to get a little cook? You want to cook a little bit? Get all cooked up? Okay, so. I don't know how much we can watch of this, because I don't know how much tolerance anybody has for this at all. But y'all, I am in love with the steamed hams meme. It's incredible. It's incredible. If you don't remember it, it's an old Simpsons sketch. You know, it's from that episode where it's like a bunch of here's a bunch of little stories, and that's what this episode is, just a bunch of little stories. And so it's only like 2 minutes, and it's Principal Skinner trying to have a good lunch, but
I would have purchased fast food,
but it always seems to go wrong the way it does for old skinny boy. And it's been the hot thing. It's been the hot meme. It's been the hot meme. And there's some I don't know. I think there's some good shit. Like, okay, how about this? Like the steamed hams, but Skinner is honest about everything. This is from One Jim, Three Bob.
Well, Seymour, I made it. Your directions were good.
Ah, Superintendent Chalmers, welcome. I hope you're prepared for an unforgettable luncheon. Oh, ye gods! My roast is ruined! But what if I were to purchase fast food and disguise it as my own cooking? Delightfully devilish, Seymour.
Okay, so pretty standard so far.
Superintendent! I were to purchase fast food and disguise it as my own cooking.
Why is there smoke coming out of your oven, Seymour?
It's smoke? My roast is ruined! I were to purchase fast food. Fast food. Superintendent, I hope you're ready for mouth-watering hamburgers.
I thought we were having Krusty Burger.
Yes, that's hamburgers.
You call it Krusty Burger. Hamburgers?
Yes.
I see. You know, these hamburgers are quite similar to steamed hams.
Yes, I purchased fast food and I call it steamed hams.
You call them steamed hams.
Oh, excuse me for 1 second.
Of course.
No.
Oh, ye gods.
Good Lord. Aurora Borealis.
Oh, that isn't Aurora Borealis. It's smoke.
Seymour, the house is on fire.
Yes.
Well, Seymour, you are an odd fellow.
Help!
Oh, it's so good. It's so good. I don't know. There's a lot of them. And I'm just saying, if we wanted to, we could spend maybe an hour looking at these. But let's not. But maybe we come back to another one later. So good. I just love it. I just love it. Let me see. Do we have any other videos here? I want to see what we've got here. We've got some stuff in the disc. Okay, so this was a thing. This was a thing I haven't even looked at. I haven't even watched this, but I know this was a hot jam. Over the past, like, what, week or so? That's it! So that's the Cantina theme from Star Wars. Played on a pencil as a girl writes out a math equation. I mean, that's good. That's good. That's exactly, it's what it is, right? They got it right. Oh my God. Oh my God. Let's see. Oh man. Let me see if we've got anything in the doc. Maybe we got some stuff in the doc. Video link sheet here at the doc. You can find the doc on the Reddit on Tuesdays or in the Discord. nanotech.tv/Discord. Here we go. Forsen tries to pronounce specimen. What's Forsen? Is that the name? Is that somebody's name?
Do you mind if I open this window?
You want to open the window?
Well, yeah, just to get it cooler without cooling down the rest of the upstairs. It's like they could still have heat. And then
okay. Yeah. Brian is opening the window to the studio.
It's frozen.
It's frozen shut. Are you sure it's not locked? Does that window lock?
It does. I don't want to say I leave it unlocked all the time, but I will say that.
I mean, I've never known a time period where it was locked, but also, like, it being frozen is very likely.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, boy. Oh. Oh? Oh?
Nope.
No?
I don't know. Maybe up here?
Push.
Yeah. Yeah, I got nothing.
Nothing.
Frozen.
Oh, man. We could just turn the fan on. Do you mind having the fan on during the show?
No.
That might help a little bit.
I could also just not wear.
That might help. Not wearing a sweatshirt. Oh yeah. So we're gonna solve the mystery of what, who or what a Forsen is. A Forsen, it's something on this video.
A Forsen?
Specimen. 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 I'm gonna say specimen. Final. Specimen. Final answer. D. Specimen.
So it's like a Twitch IRL guy. Okay.
All right.
Well, it's you know what? It's exactly what was on the tin, huh?
That's I mean, delivered. OP delivered.
Let's see. Phone a friend.
Specimen.
Specimen.
At AT&T, buy one iPhone 8 and get one on us.
This looks like
an
ad.
One for you and one for your BFF. Yeah. Your backup singer. Your frenemy. Yeah. Your boo.
Oh, he's giving a dick pic.
So one phone for you and one phone for someone in your squad.
Subtle, subtle.
That's
I like
good.
It.
Oh my god!
I'll tell you what, we're not that far from that being just you know admitted could, socially relevant. You know,
yeah, I would have like, believed that if you were like,
you know, it's like, yeah,
he's not showing pews, he's not showing dick. Of course, it could get on TV. How you doing, Brian?
I'm good.
Yeah,
bit stir crazy.
Did you go out at all today?
No.
No.
I mean, it was kind of great. You know, it's a snow day or whatever. Mm-hmm. By the way, Bonnie was convinced that I was angry all day. Like, so today was just angry. All family day. The kids are all there.
Yeah.
And so Bonnie's like, hey, we're going to do this experiment. I'm like, right on. Oh, I remember this experiment from high school. You zinc plate something, and then you you heat it, and you form a brass shell around it, and this will be fun.
Huh.
And we did that, and then it's like, oh, and then Josie needs to work on her math, so we did that for an hour. We played Overwatch, and I mean, in general, I just felt like I was dad of the century. And
sounds like a super full day, full of activities
and
with the kids.
And then Bonnie's just like, you've just been pouting all day long. And I'm like, I thought I've been pretty. I've been doing a lot of dad shit. She
You've
hates.
Got
it.
Clown makeup syndrome.
Yeah, she just sees this as a big frowny face all the time. it's gonna have to go.
Oh my gosh.
Just too bad because I enjoyed it.
Yeah. Well, so we planned on. Filming a little thing after Night
Attack
tonight.
Yeah, no, I'm going to totally prepare for that.
Okay,
yeah,
cool.
I mean, I figured, yeah, why not?
Why not?
Yeah. Are we doing just one, or?
If we can do two, I would love to do
Well, how many do we have in the bank?
We have one. So we had that episode. So we filmed that episode at Moon Tower.
Yeah.
The Cy Stebbins lie detector. It was a couple months ago. And we had an issue with the cameras, and I still haven't had a chance to go look and see if that episode is good or not.
Got it.
But I figure we either...
But then we definitely have...
Either it works, or that can be one that we film when we go out this week.
Okay. Yeah.
If it doesn't work. If it's
I'll have to remember that that particular effect.
I can send you the footage.
Yeah, all right, great.
yeah, no, that was when we're about, like... 5 or 10 minutes in. Oh, that might explain why I had trouble syncing it. The master shot just turned off.
Oh, that's not good.
No, it's not good. And it was unfortunate. That was when we're a good friend, Polymath Molly, was there.
Oh yeah, she was great.
She was fantastic.
Yeah, that was a good one.
What have we got? So, Brian, have you seen the steamed hams meme?
That sounds like when you press your butt up against that's pressed hams.
No,
when
that's
you,
yeah, that's
when
pressed
you moon
hams.
And then shove them up against the glass.
No, so steamed hams is like the Simpsons meme that's been going around.
Steamed ham, the
Skinner and Superintendent sketch from The Simpsons.
Keep going. Maybe I'm thinking of the wrong one.
So it's that episode where it's like an anthology of a lot of short stories, and they go out of lunch, but Seymour burns the roast, and so he goes and disguises it with Krusty Burger, and he's like, no, I didn't say steamed clams. I said steamed hams.
Okay, all right.
You know,
I do vaguely remember that. Yeah.
Okay, so this has been a thing on the internet for
like... Oh, to take that scene and substitute it with a bunch of stuff?
And do so much good stuff.
Oh, that's great.
So here is... steamed hams, but it's Pulp Fiction.
Well, Seymour, I made it, despite your directions.
Ah, Superintendent Chalmers, welcome. I hope you're prepared for an unforgettable engine.
Yeah, they're just listening to the
steamed hams.
Steamed hams.
That's what I call hamburgers.
You call hamburgers steamed hams?
Yes, it's a regional dialect.
In what region?
upstate New York.
Really?
You know what they call a quarter pound of a cheese?
Utica.
No.
Tell him, Vincent.
Royale with cheese.
Oh, not in Utica. No, it's an Albany expression.
I see. You know, these hamburgers are quite similar to the ones they have at
Big Kahuna Burger.
Oh, no. Patented Skinner Burgers. Old family recipe.
For steamed hams.
Yes.
Yes, and you call them steamed hams despite the fact they are obviously grilled.
You know, excuse me for one second.
Yes, I should be. Good Lord, what is happening in there?
Aurora Borealis.
Aurora Borealis. At this time of year, at this time of day, in this part of the country, localized entirely within your kitchen.
Yes.
May I see it?
No.
Well, Seymour, you are an odd fellow, but I must say, you steam a good ham.
Nice.
So, it's great. I don't know. I fell into a hole looking up the different, all the different variations of that meme.
That's one of those things where it gets funnier the deeper it goes. But then you have to, the only way to get to that giddy intoxication is to take the long trip all the way down that descending spiral.
Yeah. Cause you know, there's some really great ones, and then there's some that are like, okay.
You have iMovie.
You put time into that. Okay. let's see. Pulling a what for what? This is a Twitch clip. What do we got here?
Experience is what you have left over after you pulled a boner. Have a good day.
Okay, that's from the game show channel. Yeah,
boner.
Boner used to mean
used to socially
flub.
Mean like yeah, flub, a screw up, a challenge.
That's where all those comic panels from like Superman saying, "Oh no, I did a boner."
Yeah, exactly.
You know.
What about the shooting Grunbergs?
Oh yeah, let's see what this is. This would be maybe Grunny. Greg Grunberg shooting stars. This is from ICU. Jeez. A very specific intersection of memes.
It's pretty majestic, though. You can't deny. Just in case you thought he was done, he was not done.
Not done.
Shooting stars.
And then Chips. Okay.
Oh, that's right. That is from Chips when he gets up there and starts singing.
Starts singing. That's right.
Oh wow. Let's see. Best political speech ever.
Okay, let's see what the best.
I bet that's going to be a speech with merits.
CTV 2013 Soapbox.
Oh, mayoral candidate Soapbox.
I come from a background of diversity, an international family, and I grew up here in Edmonton, the city of champions. And do you guys remember that saying? He shoots, he scores? Yeah, that's how far back our family ties belong to in the city. My dad was one of the first pioneers. That's good.
Oh, now that's a mayoral candidate I can give.
What's so great about that is that it's only 30 seconds long. For about 25 seconds, you think, well, if she saw it, she would have said, no, let's do another take.
Yeah.
Because it's all one take. But then she ends it by saying, no, that's good.
That was good.
That's good.
And do you remember that phrase? She shoots, he shoots, he scores.
That's how far back we go.
And I'm like,
Edmonton.
Wait, how would I? Oh. God, that's great. That's a great one.
That was really good. And it's unlisted. Like, It's got 3 million views, but it's been unlisted, so I guess...
Well, I think it was always unlisted. My guess is they just had it, and it was probably like a Meet the Candidates thing that, you know, had a bunch of those embedded or something on their webpage, and then somebody said, holy shit, this is amazing, and then just sharing it.
Shave your video.
Shave your video.
Let's see. Oh, we have a flaming shot fail. While we wait for Justin to get online, you want to play a little flaming shot fail?
Yeah. Well, here, if you're getting Justin on the line, let me... No, we don't.
We're waiting for him to come online.
Save it then.
Okay, we'll save it then.
Pest control commercial.
Okay, here we go. Pest control commercial.
Arrow knows your home is susceptible to rodent infestations this winter. Cold, wet weather can attract rodents to your home.
It's a hand
and they can gain access
mouth.
With just 1/4 inch of space. They can also carry diseases such as the hantavirus and salmonella.
This
but
is
Arrow's
good.
Rodent control services will kick them out and keep them out for a whole year. Guaranteed.
Oh.
Call today to get your free consultation and we'll inspect
just,
your home.
He just chucks it
and potential
out the
entry
front
points.
Door.
Oh.
I think that's like pretty good.
Yeah, I think so. Hey. And relevant to our interests.
Justin Robert Young, hello. Oh, we don't hear you, buddy.
Whoa, mute Justin.
Yo.
There he is. How goes it?
Got Justin on the phone. Gonna do a podcast.
Oh, by the way, did you want to join me?
In tasting sake Kit Kats.
Yeah.
I assume that these were meant to be enjoyed on screen, right, Justin?
I mean, sure, yeah. I mean, they were not meant to be enjoyed. I mean, it was just a little gift from Japan.
All right, so they come in a very nice, like, decorative, protective wrapper, even.
Now, sake, can you describe the taste of sake? I mean, it's rice wine, right? So it's got kind of a tang to it.
Hey, have you never had sake?
No, I have, but I don't know how to necessarily describe it in terms of other tastes.
Okay, yeah, I would say probably like a very dry wine, but it's normally heated. So there is that kind of texture to it.
Yeah.
That warming, immersive texture.
Like a white wine.
But also, it's so kind of sour tangy that I wouldn't expect it to blend nicely with white chocolate, which is what it looks like this is.
I guess there's plenty of kinds of sake. So, I mean, I think some are a little sweeter than others.
All right, Brian's taking a bite. Ooh. Oh, the eyes tell the truth, Brian. Too sweet?
No.
Oh. There is a very like
it's
taste or
smell. It's like it's when you bite down on it, you split into two parallel realities, and in one reality you're drinking sake, and in the other you are having a Kit Kat. Mm. And the two realities don't mesh very well. It's not as easy as blending, say, the audio from your right and left ears at the same time.
I definitely got it because it was such an odd flavoring, right? I think it is definitely a stunt candy. It is like there to prove that it can taste like sake and chocolate.
They're drunk with power. They're like, we're Kit Kat. We can do anything.
Exactly.
You're chicken just, Kit Kat.
Basically.
Pizza Kit Kat.
It almost
Ed Kit Kat. Kicking all the research, the R&D people out of his office. You know, and I'm sorry, sir, it's just not possible. Like, God damn it. My father, Douglas R. Kit Kat, didn't found this fucking company for you pieces of shit to say no.
Mm. There's almost like a mint flavor. Like it comes across with like the same like cooling effect like mint.
Yeah, you know, I only had one when I bought that and an apple Kit Kat box, and I got two loose ones just so I could taste them without giving them, or you know, before, because I was gonna give one of them away. I kept the apple for myself, and I've been snacking on it.
It was good.
Yeah, it's good. That one's good.
The copy we've got in the box here for sake Kit Kat: the elegant taste of sake, wrapped in the gentle sweetness of white chocolate. Enjoy the rich, satisfying flavor of sake.
Yeah, man. So apparently the big deal with that is each region of Japan has specific things about it. And the Nagano region where we were is known for apples and sake. And so therefore they push on all the tourists, the sake and apple Kit Kats.
Yeah. Yeah, that's part of the big thing for Kit Kat's success in Japan. Beyond all the cultural stuff is that it's cheaper for them to make it in Japan and they can tap into the various areas of Japan's specialties, you know?
Yeah.
Which is cool. It's a super cool idea. And what I heard was that the reason they can do it with so many different flavors is that the price to get snack foods in convenience stores is super low in Japan.
You can just get them everywhere.
Yeah, basically. And so you can make a million different SKUs for a million different flavors, and it makes almost a collectible element to it in a weird way.
Listen, they pushed the living shit out of it, and I don't know whether or not it was just for the round eyes, but it was
sure.
Ashley had to slap me because I kept saying, whenever we went to a place with a lot of foreigners, I kept calling them round eye roundups.
Okay.
This is a real, or re-roos. It's like, I would just be like, oh, it's a real re-roo up in this bitch.
Round eye.
Round up on yeah. you.
Okay. That's awful, though.
I mean, it's our word. We're allowed to say it.
So I showed one to Brian earlier.
Dan J. Newman, did you feel like a god with how damn tall you are in Japan? I don't know how tall people think I am.
Not.
I was not all that much taller than the average Japanese person. So, yeah. I don't know what all these Dikembe Mutombo motherfuckers leaning down to look in their laptops to watch our show, but, I was not towering over anybody.
Yeah, I don't, like, I've seen Justin in person a few times, and the thing that you take away from Justin is not, that guy's tall.
No, no.
You know?
I mean, I'm not super
short. No.
I'm probably on the shallow end of average height, I would probably hazard a guess to say. Mm.
So I showed one of these to Brian earlier. How familiar, I explained this to Brian, and he had no idea about it. How tapped into the steamed hams meme are you, Justin?
I only know what you showed in the pre-show. So I am totally you introduced me to the steamed ham meme.
Oh, okay. Awesome. Well, here's another good one. This is steamed hams, but they both have crippling social anxiety. And the audio people will enjoy this. Oh, they edited the windows to not have fire in them. There you go.
That's amazing.
So you are now a week back from Japan, officially.
Yeah. Yes. We got back a week ago this morning.
Do you feel like you got the rush shaken off?
You know, I didn't really have that big of a re-entry problem. Ashley had, and we have another friend of ours that lives downstairs that's been in that really had a rough go of it, like... He's been, waking up in the middle of the night and just can't sleep and is totally fucked.
Oh,
but he was there for a little bit longer. He was there for like 2.5 weeks.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's long enough where, like, because the time difference is, like, 12 hours, basically, that you would get...
It is acclimated. A disorienting time comparative to America. Also, because America, like, even as West Coast people, you have to do a little math, you know, when you're like, okay, well, everybody else is pretty much on East Coast time, mm-hmm. so... You know, you have to kind of constantly be thinking about like where stuff is. So even then, it's like you're pretty much getting maybe a couple hours of usable business time in America. Mm-hmm. How's it like dealing with a dirty shithole again, living without a bidet? That is a huge thing, man. Every bathroom, every toilet has a bidet. There's no like a random ass 7-Eleven bidet. Nicest. Yeah, Ashley's screaming that her butt's filthy. It's great, man. It's listen, living that bidet life, it makes you realize it might be time for a bidet. I might have to pardon our old ass building to see whether or not we can get a work order to knock a hole in that wall so we can hook up a bidet.
Well, because that's the issue is you guys have a screwed up toilet that you can't just put a bidet on.
We do not have a tank. Mm-hmm. We have a elementary school,
a school toilet.
Public toilet like lever. Zoplonic says get one of the kids for your toilet. There's no tank. There's no plug in the wall to hook it into. Mm-hmm. Like, there's literally nothing. The only thing I could do with my non-regulation 1960s faucet is to find some adapter for that and literally just have my faucet turned on at all times so I can then have flowing water for a bidet.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say is, like, you could maybe find a sink kit, but then you've got it hooked up to your sink.
Yeah, because there's nowhere on the sink to hook it up to, right. Unless I went right out of the faucet, and then we'd have this crazy tube situation, which in a bathroom as small as ours, I just don't think is gonna happen.
Now, this might be controversial.
I
understand that this is coming from an exploratory committee to clean your butt.
No bad ideas in a brainstorm.
Moist towelettes.
I mean, look.
They sell them, the wet wipes.
There's no problem with them. We've had runs of moist towelettes in our house. Here's the difference, man. It ain't a bidet. Like, yes, it is a solution. It's not the solution. So, like, does it get your butt cleaner? Sure, without a doubt. Is it a warm jet of water shooting in your pooper? And just making sure everything's all clear? No. Okay. And I'll tell you what, no substitution. Once you've lived a life wrapped up in having water shoot up your butt, I don't know if anyone's ever going to go back. It's definitely been a problem.
Yeah. Well, there you go. Once you go bidet, you never say
no way.
You always say no way.
You owe it to other toilets.
To the other guys.
Yeah, to other... butts,
because you've had the best, and they.
Although I didn't understand how to use the bidet the first time I was there, first time I used it, mm-hmm. I thought it was automatically going to shut off. I thought there was like a pre-programmed,
like a time
to shoot up your butt. There's not. Mm-hmm. It will fucking. It is ride or die with your butthole for as long as you want to have that column of water shooting up there. And I did not know that I had to hit a stop button, so, like.
You just went to Flavortown for a while, huh?
I went through the moment where the warm water was just, I'm sorry, man. There's just no more. I just had cold water jet shooting up my butt. Hmm. And at that point, I'm like, wait a minute. Is that like a part of the thing? Is it like, does it warm it up with warm water?
And then cool?
Cold water for like the real business? No, I just forgot to hit the, I didn't know what the stop button was.
Now, Did you make use of the music or the noise button?
That was more primarily apparently.
It's for the ladies.
With the ladies,
Talking about the toilets.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ashley was replete with stories of all kinds of sounds that happen in women's restrooms, because apparently it used to be culture, because ladies didn't want to be embarrassed by their bodily functions, that you would flush twice. You would flush once when your body would be emitting noise.
Yeah.
And then flush once for the waste. And then apparently in the 70s, there was a water shortage. So they're like, all right, ladies, knock it off with the twice flushing. So it became very popular to have a little stereo system that would just make flushing noises constantly. So you would be able to like time out when you're or, you know, there would be, I don't know, other stuff. But there's lots of noises. Oh, there was one that was a safari. There was a lot of like
safari.
Oh my god!
It starts off as like a peaceful jungle, and then you hear oh god, no, and it's you're suddenly listening to an audio drama, complete with barbarians at the gates.
Well, it's got like a microphone, so it'll play like lion attack sounds.
Yeah, exactly. It'd be good if it went based on how active the bathroom was. Like if it was like a real high traffic time, it would just be like, you know, Tokyo at rush hour. If it was like really quiet, it would be something kind of more spare.
Oh, yeah.
So someone sent in a flaming shot fail.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this one's unique. I think it's rather unique. Only 13 views.
What?
Yet it was published in October 2013.
From Best New Fail Videos.
Of course. I mean, it's the best, so that's why I'm really surprised there's only 13 views.
Man, you ever noticed that the best at anything never needs to put the word the best in it?
Hmm.
Like, can you name one premium best brand of anything that has... And like, the worst are ones that seem like they're talking about something else. Like, Seattle's best coffee? I'm like, oh, you must be talking about Starbucks. You're like, no, we're nope. Seattle's best coffee.
We're Seattle's best.
Yeah, you're like, no, but you're asking me which is the best coffee from Seattle. It's Starbucks. No.
Man, what? There's got to be somebody. There's something that is the best that's actually the best.
Milwaukee's best? No.
Best Buy is definitely not.
Best Buy at one point.
Best Buy was.
Best Buy was. So yep. At one point in history, Best Buy was indeed the Best Buy.
Mike TV says Best Foods. Is that a thing? Is there a place called Best Foods?
GMC for show definitely is the best.
Was the best. Yeah. Is the best as he claims in his song.
In any case, we've got Flaming Shot Fail here. We'll get ahead of a few frames here to kind of get a look at the landscape. It looks like
bestiality.
Oh,
I'm sure someone out there thinks it is.
So this looks like maybe they're doing a shot, a little shot pipe. I think we might have seen. I know we've seen one involving a shot pipe, and it was pretty bad. I remember it being specifically bad. What do you guys think happened in this flame?
I mean, this is straight up Bluebeard, right? That's an awkwardly made vessel. That's gonna
I'm going to go a yoga flame, though.
Oh, okay. All right, let's take a look. Let's go back.
You hold it in your mouth. You suck it in your lap. All right, time out.
Also,
new vector of information. The guy running, the guy explaining, his face is blurred out as if to make sure no legal culpability comes of what happens next.
I mean, it's the best news fail videos. You know, they're professionals.
I'm sure they are. Yeah. I'm sure they
are.
Come
on, what kind of fucking horse shit fail video operation do you think they're running here?
But also, the bartender or whoever this guy at this counter is explaining how to do this shot.
How to
this
drink
gentleman.
A shot.
Yeah, out of this, like, it looks like a pipe.
Oh my god, if you dip. It's just a big pipe. Mm-hmm. And he says, don't blow inside. If that thing is on fire and you did blow,
you would be shooting fire.
That would be a literal flamethrower. That would be a literal weapon.
Flame spinner,
of.
But okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. All right.
Also, the liquor inside is blue. I don't know. I don't think that's a refraction thing. I think he might be drinking Listerine. All right, it's lit.
Oh! Sorry, Justin and I just got breaking news. But
yeah,
also,
what the fuck?
Yeah, yeah. What the fuck, indeed. All right, we'll. All right, we'll talk.
One thing at a time.
There was a flaming shot of news that came came our way.
I can't decide which is the bigger shit show, the video or the news we just got.
Let's finish this.
All right.
Okay.
All right.
So we'll relive the glory.
This was also some shit that fucking happened in 2013 that for whatever reason is relevant in 2013.
Oh, Jesus.
So he just blows.
So he does drink. He is starting to successfully drink.
No, he's not.
Oh, no!
Well, he drinks too fast. That's what it is.
Self-flame bukkakis. He causes the other dude to have a Hadouken.
Oh,
it's a Hadouken, a Bluebeard, a Ghost Rider, a Doubtfire.
Get in your car. Drive away.
Oh, my gosh.
That might have been the closest we ever got.
I mean,
to a possible Knight Rider.
Well, it's I mean, if you had the bingo card, you almost won a blackout game of bingo on there.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Let's play a game of 20 questions. Okay. What news item did both Justin and I get forwarded at the exact same moment?
Is it was it before 2015? Did it occur before 2015?
No, it happened. It was posted.
Probably should have.
Yeah, probably should have. It was posted 1 hour ago.
Posted an hour ago. Was it on a national news site?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, Jesus. Is it political?
No.
No? Okay. That's three. Hold on. Is it entertainment?
Sure.
Would it be in the entertainment section?
Yes.
Okay.
Ish. Yes.
Ish. Oh, shit. is the person it's about a celebrity?
Sure.
To our audience.
Yeah.
Certainly.
Oh, geez.
Yeah.
Okay. Is it the thing I'm seeing in chat?
Yep. yep.
Really?
Huh. 1 hour ago. Twit is suing Twitter for breach of contract and trademark infringement.
Oh, that's not the thing I was thinking of.
No.
Okay.
Yeah, no, that's a thing. TechCrunch article. As the story goes, Twitter co-founder Evan Williams had previously told Leo Laporte Twitter was simply a text-based microblogging service, the lawsuit states.
Oh, Jesus.
But now they're doing video, and they can't do video.
Oof,
by the way, I mean, look, I was probably my most avid Twit listener when Twitter debuted.
Yep.
And Leo tried to use every card he could to kill that service. He wanted to make Twitter Friendster in the worst way and would talk mad long before. You are all Twitter hipsters when you're like, I don't know, I'm not having fun. Leo was shitting on Twitter within months of it becoming popular and tried to fucking kill it a million different times.
Do you remember when we had like on our second or third episode of NSFW when Dane was Danger Dane was talking to us. He was like, okay, I sent you a picture. However, I used this service. We don't use TwitPic here. Because of copyright infringement. And I was like...
Which, by the way, TwitPic is not a Twitter property, was not a Twitter property, but okay. Yeah.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter. Plus also...
Oh,
jeez.
Hey, remember Jaiku? I do, because Leo made it the big thing for as long as anybody would pretend that Jaiku was a thing. Remember Plurk? I do, because Leo made it a big thing because he wanted to kill Twitter. There was no doubt that they had a boner for that. Seems like
not the most timely. I'm gonna go out on a limb and bet that they don't have the most solid paperwork on that one.
I don't know. TechCrunch.com for more information.
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead and read all about it. Look, man. What are you gonna do?
All right.
You know what's funny is like one of the things they have to do is they have to show that they've been financially damaged, and they have to point to stuff. And it occurs to me that I don't know. Seems like you could point to a traffic mark about 4 years ago, after which there was a precipitous decline. that they might be able to say that's the fault of Twitter.
I mean, look, they at the time took active measures against the platform by actively blocking old hosts.
That's true. Oh my God. I want to read, do they have any pull quotes on there or anything?
They have some quotes from the lawsuit.
A permanent injunction. That's all they're asking. They're just asking Twitter to, hey, knock it off with the video, guys.
Exactly.
Yeah, from what I browsed very quickly in that TechCrunch article, Twit and Twitter came to an agreement to not that their trademarks would be not competing so long as they stayed in their lane.
This was ancient history. Like,
yeah,
this
ten years ago.
Like 10 years ago, ancient history.
And I guarantee you nothing in writing. I guarantee you it was a handshake or like they're gonna point to the actual tweets. Will be what they do.
Sure, like, yeah. Look at this tweet. Like, it was probably at the point where Twitter thought they could gain from talking to Leo, like back when they were a younger service and wanted to differentiate themselves in a very, very crowded scene. Even then, I mean, look, that's the point where what? MySpace is still alive. Like, Facebook has probably yet to overtake MySpace. Like, that was a younger younger days.
It was so Pistini. What if he died?
I remember. This breaking news. Twit now also suing Night Attack for use of proprietary characters, Postini. And the following. And they're even retaining Ira Sockman. No!
No!
I have like to make my lawsuit now against Post-its.
Against by and what about Postmates? How about that?
And Martinis.
I went to the Postmates and I asked him, "You're not going to sell Italian food?" And they say to Postini, "Yes, no Italian food. Now I get a chicken piccata."
Oh, God, I want to hear all the character witnesses at this trial. Hey, y'all, it's me. Well, there was a bit of a hullabaloo a while back, and I had to come in because, you know, Justin Robert Young couldn't do the ads right. I had to teach him how to get the news out.
The character witnesses.
It's like that last episode of Seinfeld where all of the sins. Can we call Leo's dick to the stand?
Jesus Christ. I'm not going to make the joke. Leave the joke there. I want to leave that one.
Oh.
Fuck. Who would be some of the other character witnesses that would be called? Called
Obama?
Obama?
What's your one? Yeah, yeah, sure, you know. Yeah, yeah, sure. You don't just got a Twitter. They only say to Leo Laporte. You video or audio. Obama say, but
Then the lawyer says, "You're witness," and then the opposing attorney says, "Hey, mister, what do you think you're doing? Posting your microblogging sites using the Twit handle?"
Well, of course, like, which party is represented by Ira Sockman?
Both.
I play both sides. Vagina ball to the stand.
I love lawsuits. I love them.
And Steve McDill, Tudor.
I just went over to Twitter and I said, "Hey, are you guys not gonna do any video or things you'd say on a laser disc?"
Oh.
Oh,
fuck. Oh. Remember characters, guys?
Oh.
But
Oh, this is great.
Well, and then of course, Murhoy, I'm going to stay out of any trademark infringement, dives off the boat.
Wait for me! The capital is Sacramento! Oh.
Oh, God. Jesus.
So, yeah. Oh, we did get some Photoshops over the past week. So, someone took, I guess it was a screen grab from last week's episode when we were talking about the hosting thing in Japan and made this.
Yes. I don't see any difference. I would appreciate it. They could have at least changed the face on there.
Photoshop?
They could have put you in there if you're gonna put the word. They just added the word Bryce underneath.
Bryce underneath.
They took the existing billboard and just put Bryce.
Well, so someone else found a billboard of a church. A church, one of those signs out in front of a road sign out in front of a church that said, what is it? Getting wet for Jesus. And then and then cropped that Photoshop very specifically so the yellow background looked like a halo.
Oh.
Of me.
Your what do they call it? A gilded, enlightened copy? What do they call it when they draw the golden halos around the people? I guess they call it drawing golden halos around people.
Hey, wait, hold on. Wait a minute. We're just getting another character witness. What y'all motherfuckers know about lawsuits? We got legally binding agreements up in this shit. Twit hype man. People don't forget, motherfucker. Blah, blah, blah.
You're like I'm like that Sprint guy that used to be with Verizon. Now I'm the Twitter hype man.
Twitter hype man. Yeah, they stole me too.
These motherfuckers know their shit.
These motherfuckers know their legal rights. Subpoena hype man.
Subpoena hype man.
Oh, fuck.
God, who had we had a few characters.
That we did.
Can we have 1 hour of inside jokes from 3 years ago? What do you think's happening now, brother?
Yeah, we're getting in the zone.
I know, I feel like every 12 months we do an episode that's just doing old bits.
Breaking alert. Is it not true? You're like, now you claim your spoons to be world famous. Are they in fact world famous, Mr. Smokey?
they took away my spoons. I want to take away the worst spoons.
Oh.
Man, it's going to be hilarious when accidentally one of the exhibits is a picture of Leo's dick.
Accidentally?
Not that one. Not that one. Move it on.
he gets up and he's scrolling. He's like, well, I have a bunch of witnesses here. Let me just scroll through them. Oh, yeah. How do I can't close this? Oh, golly. Oh. Just keeps happening to me. I don't know.
They make him recreate the exercise ball popping scene.
They've got like a forensic 3D recreations of it.
They get that Chinese company that makes all the news clips to make to do that recreation.
Yeah, the Taiwanese news.
Boing, boing, they, boing.
you know they did one of those on him. Did
they? They did?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I didn't. I don't know that.
Somebody will find a link. But, like, at the time of the infamous dick pic, they did one of really? Those things. Yes, it's really worth it's probably worth looking at now that it's been a few years.
Obabaya says the lawsuit insists that they call the shows netcasts.
This just in, press release, Leo Laporte to twitch.tv. You're next. Come on. I know you got deep pockets, Jeff Bezos.
Jeff Bezos when reached for comment.
Animal Fairy's here to slew you.
Now, Animal Fairy, is it true that you, as far as you know, Twitter and Twit had no agreement?
No, as the lemur knows in the dead of night, that you make a promise once, it's for you. A promise twice is for the moon.
sorry, could you answer
the... Apple Fairy, I'm me. I know, as wise as the old owl, that if you promise, you must deliver. That's the owl's call to justice. Anyway, see you later.
That's the owl's calls to justice. All right, now we're going to take a 4-minute recess while we listen to Herbert Hoover, jazz musician. Oh, he's doing the triple trill. There it is.
Sunbud says, Kylo stole it from the fairy.
Oh. Oh my god. Oh, the character. This, it's like fucking the shittiest version of Cartoon All-Stars, but they're just a fucking local court in San Francisco.
Oh. It's the worst episode of Wacky Racers.
All right, Danger Dane Golden play those tapes of him cursing.
Oh my god, my eyes are watering. This is the fucking, this is the most lit pre-show in history.
Oh, Kustra on the chat says, sorry for the clip show. I think you mean you're welcome.
This yeah. is great. Do you mean Twigasa?
We rewatched that episode on the rewind on one of these weekend streams at one time, and like it's that's a very like memorable episode, right? It's got the Tuigasa bit.
Oh no, but it's so sloppy.
But it's super sloppy, and there are like two other bits that kind of just like fall out of their face.
Yeah,
so, like it's really funny. But also, I mean, they're just like not.
So yeah. Courageous. So courageous.
So brave. So brave.
Jurors, how do you find? We find the plaintiff an asshole.
No, he's moved on. There's Max Trollbot's actually a he's trying to swing the election on Twitter.
Oh yeah.
You guys want to do a show?
Oh, good times.
Got literally crying. This is like the funniest shit.
Oh.
Yeah, good luck.
We wish them the best in their future endeavors.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Twit might get paid. I mean, Twitter might just pay to make it go away. Although I would suspect that they probably ask for money.
This does sound like...
Because Twitter's not going to stop doing video and audio.
Well, yeah. Or live streaming. However, you know what? The timing of this is so odd. That it makes me feel like somebody just discovered an old email and then was just like, oh, I have an email. Don't you see? This is a written thing saying they wouldn't do it. And then they've done it. And now we can stir up a little bit of hoopla.
Maybe. So we have.
I have no doubt that they. I mean, because Leo doesn't forget. Believe us. He's been pissed about this forever. And
well, he seems easy to forgive, though. Like, he just seems real chill.
Well, now, Brian, why, yes, you know, appearances. And would this seem?
Oh, Bobama's. Are you painting there a conspiracy here, Bobama?
Look. It's all on the internet if you want to see every inch of the Austin Twit stuff. And in all honesty, we're having a good time, but there's no ill will between you know, us and Twit, bygones be bygones and everything. But I don't doubt it. If, yeah, I mean, like, he's been pissed about that shit for as long as Twitter's been a thing. And now they are moving more and more. And then they're saying publicly, we're a media company, like, we want to do video and audio and stuff like that. So if they're paying to create their own shit, then I can understand where he's like, well, by the way, I don't just go away.
And we've reported on Cord Killers, cordkillers.com, a lot about Twitter, you know, getting streaming rights for sports. They just launched TikTok, I think, with Bloomberg for the news channel. You know, like, you know, maybe this is exactly what it says on the tin. Who knows?
Yeah.
You guys want to do a show? You guys wanna do,
yeah, I'm debating on whether or not I can nurse half a beer for the whole remainder of this evening, though. I think I might need a preventative.
Don't take the chance.
Mm. No.
If you go down, can you get me one of those fruity things?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah. By the way, that statement was kind of a Rorschach taste.
Rorschach
test.
Dr. Freud.
when you said don't risk it, I just realized I was like, oh, I shouldn't drink at all. And I was like, oh, no, don't risk not having it.
Yeah, don't risk thinking that you can go with half a beer. You
Right.
You said you like the peach better than the mango.
Oh, yes, please. Thank you for good memory. All right, if we have time, I'm going to play one more Steamed Hams.
All right, somebody was saying that there's priceless wording in that lawsuit. If you have priceless wording, then just go ahead and post that.
Yeah, if you find something, let us know.
I doubt anybody would find it interesting of me just looking at a screen for 30 minutes while I read it, so... yep. Do the work for me.
See, I want to find one of these that's like, this one's kind of stupid. Steamed hams, but it's sexy and stylish. Oh wait, hold on, I got it.
Well, sir, I made it despite your directions.
Jaws, Lieutenant Chalmers, welcome. I hope you're prepared for an unforgettable
star.
Oh. No!
My star is ruined.
But what if I were to purchase food and disguise it as my own
star?
I'm gonna.
This is one that is like really good when you spent a half hour in the hole.
in the ham hole.
In the ham hole. Yeah. All right. Well, I think we're just about ready to get started with the show.
Wait, there's not another steamed ham we can steam up real quick.
Okay, here's one. This one's fun. But I think it might also be a niche thing. Here we go. KK Sliders steam hams.
Yeah, what's a KK slider?
So yeah, it's a
that a racist hamburger.
No, it's Animal Crossing. There's a popular character.
Got it.
And so it's using the sound font from that.
Okay. Yes. Well, all right. Next time we can go back.
Steamed hams, but Skinner dies halfway through.
Okay. Yes. Here we go. This one's solid. Anybody will get this.
Well, Seymour, I made it, despite your directions.
Ah, Superintendent Chalmers, welcome. I hope you're prepared for an unforgettable luncheon.
Yeah.
Oh, ye gods! My roast is ruined!
But what if I were to purchase fast food and disguise it as my own cooking? Delightfully devilish, Seymour.
Crazy explanations.
The
superintendent's gonna need his medication. When he hears Skinner's lame exaggerations, there'll be trouble in town tonight.
Seymour! Superintendent, I was just stretching my calves on the windowsill. Isometric exercise. Care to join me?
Why is there smoke coming out of your oven, Seymour?
That isn't smoke. It's steam. Steam from the steamed clams we're having. Mmm, steamed clams.
Ooh. he just got hit by a car, and now it's just a superintendent.
Why is there smoke? Good Lord, Seymour.
It was a dream. Oh shit.
Oh, okay. So people are giving us quotes from the twit lawsuit. Mm. It is a breach of oral agreement and breach of implied contract.
Someone said earlier that they had one of the Twitter guys on one of the shows. Quote, for this, it might be Kyle. One of the Twitter's founders literally came on one of the shows and said that everything was cool and they won't be competing with them.
I would say that they're still not in competition with each other.
I don't know. One of them's going to want to get that spot for, what, seventh place in streaming media?
All right.
Maybe? Okay. Let's do a show. You guys want to do a show?
Yep. I'm feeling it.
If you haven't tweeted yet, you got about 48 seconds.
I should tweet.
We're at twitch.tv/nightattack. Follows are free, and so is telling your friends.
Twitch.tv.
All right. I'm going to... that's not what I wanted. We're going to go here. Going to do this. Little whoopsie, little do. Where's my thing? Otfi? Where's my Otfi? There he is. All right. Like I said, this one's a little shorter, so just a heads up everybody's display. Test this. Great. All right, here we go.